The covered surface hugs the board but keeps in the sky. A child, a glimpse that keeps you warm but hangs you to dry. The shameful dream, the shameful face that pulls on your heart. Those brittle winds will keep the dawn from you at the start. So bring me choirs to ease me on my way. Bring me screams of organs for the day. Bring me choirs to brighten all the gales. Bring me screams of organs and the wails of winter tales. A winter tale is it's raw and it's honest and it's got a wintry kind of harshness to it. There's nowhere to hide on it, you know. We did it all live, all the vocal takes are live with the band. A storm of roadside pines. To the point when we're recording, I can't hear what the pianist did or the electric guitar's doing. All I could hear was the drums and myself. No one had, actually the drummer had headphones on, but everyone else just had a little speaker next to them. And all they could hear was my vocal. And we were playing and then all of a sudden walk into the control room and suddenly hear, you know, all these layers of sound. Lord and sorrow thrown into the day. I was brought up in Wiltshire. It's not too far away from Stonehenge and Avebury and Druid culture and stuff like that. There's not a lot of stuff to do. There was no cinema in the town or anything. There's like 8 pubs and one school. I always struggled at school, like badly struggled at school. It was like no matter what I did, I would always get that same like C minus, you know. I just couldn't fit my head around school and so bring me choirs to ease me on my way. So bring me screams of organs for the day. So bring me choirs to brighten on the gale. So bring me screams of organs at the wheel. Win a tale. I always love words, but and was always trying to use words in different ways, and just I was always interested in like how words looked on the page, like how words lined up alongside each other, but I didn't necessarily have the understanding, but I wanted the understanding. I was just amazing, like the only teacher I think I ever really kind of really liked. She gave me this Dylan Thomas book. She was kind of the only one who thought I had something, I think. My other English teachers thought I just wasn't trying very hard, and you know, and I hated them, you know, I really hated them. Shameful dream, a shameful face, a pause on your heart. Everything I listened to was 50s, 40s, 60s or something. It was blues, jazz, weird stuff. So bring me screams of organs for the day. I got brought up on like Louis Armstrong and Jack Teagarden and loads of the old jazz guys like Hoagy Carmichael and people like that, you know, the writings of those guys. As for my grandpa, he just listened to jazz stuff. He was like a wine-drinking like connoisseur of jazz, you know, just be like, oh, you know, he's trying to sing along with Louis, you know. I got given the Spanish guitar, you know, one of those cheap ones, and I didn't pick it up again until I was 16. My dad always played to us as kids and played his old folk songs. My dad does a lot of finger picking stuff, and I only finger pick with these two fingers, you know, and he does that too, and it must have washed over me a little bit, and I started just writing little finger picking stuff.
Now I will run you.
I didn't start singing till a lot later.
Like a thread.
And I just kind of started writing songs, but really intensely.
'Cause my worried eyes.
I just went, I need to write a song every Saturday night.
We'll see again.
I didn't go out on Saturdays for a long time.
May peace wear the sky.
I think I have more of a concern for the on the lyrical side than I do with the melody. It's often like a combined thing. I'll sit down and start playing something, but the melody and me, the guitar is just a structured backbone for the lyrics.
Now I will fall upon this town to call your name, my sweet suffragette.
I didn't start playing on my own until I moved to London.
Now I will fall upon this town.
When I was about 18 and a half.
My sweet suffragette, my sweet Mary Jane, my sweet Mary Jane.
And then I played nearly every night, you know. I played at different open mic nights. I didn't even really know if I wanted to just be a performer or a writer at that stage either. I was just, I loved to write and that was what I wanted to do. And the performing side, you know, I found much harder. That was the best thing about open mic. You did meet quite a lot of people, like-minded people, and that's kind of what happened to me. I met my friend Rob, and he was a musician too, and he was hanging out with a few of his other friends who were musicians as well. I became friends with them, and then for the first time, I felt like I had made friends who were similar to myself. You know?
For you, my. For you, my love.
Rob ended up, you know, being an actor and stuff, and I co-wrote this song, and he ended up taking this song to the film's producers.
So barricade the doors and stop the heart that you've been holding. Throw the words you hold so dear from the letter you've been softly folding.
And I was like, oh great, well, you know, that'd be really cool. Didn't really think about it. Yeah, it went in. It was far bigger than I thought it was. And, you know, the film was Twilight, and it's kind of ridiculous.
Stranger taking his last breath upon the guillotine.
And I was suddenly getting like 2,000 plays on MySpace, you know. From getting like 20 a day to 2,000 a day, and it was all really kind of kicking off. I was a musician and I was unsigned in London. And I still can't quite put my finger on it. I don't know why that I got so exposed at that time. Suddenly, do you want to go over to America? Like, well, please come to Kentucky. Please come to Canada. Please come to Hawaii. They wanted to, I think it was just their own want of knowing everything about this film, and I was tied into that. I think, you know, it escalated when I went over there and played so much and got down and dirty with, you know, with playing all these shows, that they really started to jump on it.
Oh, you, my love. Oh, you, my love. Does your heart beat so softly without warning? Does it beat out to the slow pace of the morning? Oh, when you close your eyes, and after all that you see, we let the strangers be.
Just blew up. And I was still studying at this point, so I had 2 weeks off for Easter. So we went over to America and played in New York, LA and Nashville. And all the shows were sold out, you know, it was crazy. Came back and then I went on tour for 2 months straight, and we just slept on people's floors and played around America.
train, it hits the railroad and it cowers under flies.
And then all of a sudden, we came back to England and then for like a week and went back out again for another 2 months. Then I came back to England again and I was exhausted, and then I started to record my album. Just before I was about to head out on tour to America for the first time, I met Liam Watson because he was producing my best friend's band called The Spivs. And I met him and he loves the same music that I love.
Oh, when the world holds out its flag, the sun will fall across the plain. I will hold out my hands and take the blame.
He's got this amazing studio just up the road from where me and my friends live, like literally just up the road. I think, you know, I was like, I would love to record at your place. And it's like, yeah, come down, let's record some songs. So I went down there and recorded like 15 acoustic songs. Shame. And he didn't really say that much. The biggest thing I got from him was when I started playing a Hank Williams song. He was, oh, what's that? I was like, it's Hank Williams. He goes, yeah, great song. Finished up the record and we did like 18 songs in the studio. We did them all live.
And if someone is hurt, then it's gonna be me. For the tears that take your heart, you're so happy that you're free. And if you're no better now than you've ever been,
Liam was like incredible to work with, because, you know, he didn't really have to take me on as much as he did, but he made me feel at home and made sure I was in the driving seat. He really gave me confidence to push forward what I wanted to push forward. You know, it'd be great to manipulate the exact sound of the record, but I just want to get out there and play. If it sounds a little bit different, that's no big deal to me.
And I said you owe me an apology, an apology.
It's just getting out there, just getting dirty and being dangerous and stuff.
I said you owe me an apology. My sweet.